Blackstone presents Last Liar Standing, a novel by Danielle M. Wong. This book is read by Nancy Wu. For Brian, forever missed, forever loved. Prologue. The average person has 13 secrets right now. That's all I can think about as I step through the double doors of this rundown motel. Its lobby looks like something straight out of the 1960s, with faux wood paneling and marmalade orange armchairs. I clutch my bag tightly and cringe at the peeling shreds of outmoded wallpaper. There's a uniformed woman crammed behind a cluttered desk, some sort of makeshift reception counter. She morphs her glossy red lips into a strained smile and flashes it in my direction. But the only thing I can focus on is her exhausted expression. She resumes sorting through a mess of documents before I attempt a weak grin in return. A quick scan of the remaining area tells me that I am not alone. My shoulders creep up as I count the guests inside. Not just a few, either. 10 others wait to check in. Why is it so crowded? My entrance garners more than a couple curious glances, and I immediately glue my eyes to the tiled floor. Of the odd assortment of guests, many are seated in pleather swivel chairs scattered across the room. A 40-something woman in a blue dress perches on the sole sofa as a conspicuously older gentleman snoozes beside her. Are they together? Sinking into the puffy upholstered fabric is tempting after the long drive here, but I decide to stand in line regardless. I take my place behind a petite woman with 2 enormous Louis Vuitton suitcases. She could probably fit inside her own luggage. She smacks her gum over the elevator music, humming in the background. I stifle an eye roll and silently hope that the line starts moving soon. When it finally does, the woman struggles with the handle of our larger bag. It's jammed. Just as I think about offering assistance, a middle-aged man in khaki pants and loafers jumps up to help. She thanks him in a chirpy voice and continues moving. He looks her up and down, adjusting the groin area of his Dockers before finally breaking a creepy stare. I don't even bother to suppress my eye roll this time. Across the lobby, a young couple argues. Though their words are inaudible, their body language is unmistakable. It sends chills down my spine. He grabs her wrist, his knuckles turning bone white, before she pries her arm from his grasp and whispers something in a hushed tone. I look away and try desperately to shake off the thought threatening to detonate my composure. When I glance back toward them, the woman is turned away, facing the window. Her skin glistens with tears and snot in the murky reflection. Bark cloth curtains frame another window on the left side of the room. It was still dark outside when I parked, but a vivid sunrise is rapidly illuminating the sky. A flurry of color floods the horizon, wicked splashes of orange, yellow, and rose. I watch briefly before turning my attention back to the line in front of me. My heartbeat quickens when I realize that I am still at the end of it. This is taking too long. I practice slow inhalations like Dr. Flynn taught me, but this place reeks of cigarette smoke. I inevitably fixate on an incessant clicking sound and find myself scouring the room for its source. My shoulders drop when I identify the noise, a teenager tapping his thumbs rhythmically against a bright phone screen. I wonder if he is composing a text message or playing a game. Maybe he's stalking an ex on social media. We accidentally lock eyes, and I immediately look away. Letting my gaze linger for more than a moment feels too risky. I can't afford to be seen here, let alone recognized. I fish a pair of jet black aviators out of my purse, then throw them on like a mask. The average person has 13 secrets right now. This is what I think about while my anxious stare lands on the far wall. Aged photographs hang in mahogany frames.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.